Viecher.
Yellow Dane, Yellow Dane, he is bold as he is bold.
We will fight,
but we are the ice and grim. We are Dane to Yellow Dane.
Hey everybody, welcome to MWO Leagues, or Comp, or whatever it is they call it, but this is specifically the Marshall Olympiad Reborn 2, which is confusing because, does that mean there was there originally a Marshall Olympiad, then it was reborn, and then it was reborn twice? It's just a lot. That's all I'm saying. It's just a lot. this week, we've got JGX versus NPC, aka Bowser's team. So cool. Fortunately, these are the top two teams in the Marshall Olympiad Reborn 2 Gangnam Style whatever. And unfortunately, JGX has so many more points than NPC that it doesn't matter. The outcome doesn't matter. JGX has already won the division. It's 45-33. That's the JGX is 45. No pre-course is 33. Each point is a win, so after tonight, I mean, best case scenario is NPC is 38 and JGX is still 45. And this is the last match of the week, of the entire tournament. So, mathematically impossible for NPC to actually win regardless of the matches. Hooray! Bye everybody. As always, I've got Chef Lord with me, or not always, but most of the time. Sale was here once. Yeah. All right, just looking at the lobby. Oh, they wanted me to move someone, and I didn't because I wasn't paying attention, and it looks like they got it sorted. So, good for everybody. Yeah. So unfortunately, this drop doesn't matter, but it'll still be good to see the two highest ranking teams fight it out. It'll be exciting. I assume that's why most people are here. I recognize a lot of Team One, seen them for a long time, you know, Krapanoski, Dario, Data, Pasha, Navid. I mean, they're all long time MWO competitive, high ranking members. Kong Lord, Bowser, Texas Scrub Lord. I don't actually recognize anybody else over there. I don't know who that is. If you do, it's good for you. I haven't played 10 matches a month for the last 4 years, so I only recognize people who played this game more than 5 years ago. Team one is locked, and when team two is locked, we will drop. This is Terra Therma. You know, traditionally this is a not a great map for Laser Vomit. You know, I think PPCs can do well here. This is normally this is a map you want a lot of Daka in, or SRMs. But when I say normally, I mean 5 years ago. Who knows? Who knows today? We did that once. So, yeah, we will see, and we will be excited by what we see. Gotta add you. Yep, that sounds perfectly regular. So yep, we're just waiting for Team Two to lock, and then we'll jump right into this match, see how it goes, see what they do, so that everybody else can imitate them, because that's what you do. Is NPS is no pre-courses? Is it NPS? I see nobody on their team actually has that tag. NPC, not S. I think I've seen people say that, but right. Basically, they want no branding. They're just a mercenary team. All right, both teams are locked. I'm going to switch view modes and then drop it so that I don't mess up and nobody can watch. All right, hopefully I didn't screw it up. You know, someone mentioned to me, they're like, why don't you have a cam? So I went and found it, and now I have one. They are on their drop ships, and now they are moving. Hooray! Let's get some stuff up here so we can see what's going on. Two fire starters for JGX, Phoenix Hawk, Viper, two Annihilators, two Nightjars. A lot of twos. People, I'm gonna jump through their mechs real quick, or Bowser. So we see Bowser's mech, ERP PC boat, AC-10 boat for the night gear, small ERP PC, small laser, the Annihilators for nope, we're not in JGX yet, ERP PC like Gauss, like PPC. Gonna span through here real quick so everybody has this, sees what everybody's bringing, if even just for a second. All right. So both teams. Team of two. All right, NPC has grabbed two, and JGX has also grabbed two caps. So they're both fighting over two caps at the moment. Yeah. So they're just fighting over Theta right now for the most part. You've got a few lights in the backfield that are this flea and a fire starter doing back caps for both teams watching them. Right now it's all about. It goes Pop-Tarting in his Summoner Prime, so is Timuid. Now, right now, you'll see that we only have, looks like, well, these guys are back here looking for opportunities, but. I think JGX is winning the trades here. I think with their guys to the left and the right, they're able to kind of pinch, especially McGoat and Drimwood. Switch sides. Just gives them a little bit of a wider kind of firing arc. Both teams are using pretty similar builds, ER, PPC, trades. Are they actually fighting back here? Let's see, the Firestarter and the Flea are. Otherwise. I mean, really, the damages between the trades are fairly even at the moment. Seeing how these guys. So we've got the Annihilator up front, and then Pasha's jumping up behind the Annihilator. I mean, Pasha. That's how you say that name. Pasha. My mistake, Pasha. And then over here, you've got the other Nightjar and another Annihilator. So they've, you know, JGX has stacked an Annihilator and a Nightjar working together on these two corners. Whereas over here with the NPC, you've got the Summoner and the Nightjar, I think, having similar duties, both Pop-Tarting up front. Bowser in the back, and then their Annihilator Kong Lord also in the back. So, two Pop-Tarts. So it looks like something may be about to transpire. So you can see here, Data and Pasha are able to also cover the backfield as well. So they've turned around to lob fire over that way. I don't know if that's altering the rest of the battle, though. Yeah, they haven't changed their trading much, but you're right, there's now well, Bowser's moved up. So yeah, both sides have then pulled from their traders to help in this battle over Sigma. Pel Krapanowski is on Pelisara. Trying to get that kill. Meanwhile, the Nightjar, specifically Pshaw, is able to keep the rest of those mechs kind of pinned back. They did a. Yeah, NPC's got four mechs here, just looking at Sigma, unable to move down because of really the fire coming from Pshaw, but I think their fire starters also have PPCs that they're lobbing at him as well. Data is kind of straddling, or was straddling, and then these other three mechs, I don't know what they've been doing. I mean, I'm sure they've been trading, but I don't know if they've been helpful, if they've been impactful. I think Jiffy and Grolish have been holding them off. Just basically fighting a battle that to keep each other tied up. Yeah, we can see here that Navid and Krapanowski have both moved up. They are also trading, so they are participating in the fight. Krapanowski is now up in their faces, just screening, slowing down any movement. The end. Though only one mech died, but I mean, it was all about control, and that's, what a conquest match should be. About control. I mean, yeah, you can see Dario, Krapanowski, Polycat. Not big damage from them, but they did what they needed to do, which was keep the other team from capping for the most part. For the traders, the Annihilator Grolsch was in, did really well. Jiffy also did well. They were together in the same location, so maybe they had better shots than the other traders. Pshaw and Data did have to pull off to help the other group, mostly, I think more Pshaw than Data. Not able to. Kind of a not a huge damage game. Only one mech died, but a control match, well executed. I will throw that up on our little map strap thing. And then if you want to briefly sketch that out while I switch the team or the lobby around. City domination. Domination. Don't you love that tool? What a useless tool. All right. So I see you drawing. Let me grab a nice. So there's a little bit of a story in the numbers. So we have for JGX two annihilators and two nightjar. And the two annihilator or the annihilator and one nightjar was set up here. One annihilator and one nightjar was set up here. So that's four mechs dedicated to capping or not capping, but to controlling in the trade game at Theta. Whereas I think NPC actually had only three mechs. They had Bowser back here, and then they had a summoner and a nightjar here. Oh no, they had four. They had that annihilator too. All right, so yeah, both teams had four mechs initially set up to do that. And then, I mean, JGX just Sigma is right there on their fire, right there next to one of their firing approaches. Which allowed them, as we saw, to pull off Pasha down here to support when NPC made a push for it. So really, they just set up to control these three points, and they were able to effectively do it. Rough situation for NPC. I don't immediately know what they could have done against that. Yes. Just because, I mean, you can see where they're set up. They have eyes on Theta, but they also have eyes on Epsi, and they've got eyes on Theta, and they've got eyes on Sigma. Whereas, it's not nearly as strong for NPC setup. Like, yeah, they control Gamma, sure. They don't even really, like, I mean, maybe, I'd have to look at the angles. Maybe, do you think he could see Kappa from me? Like, how well, could Bowser cover Kappa? I mean, so yeah, they really only control Gamma, and they kind of control Kappa, and so just the initial setup really does favor where JGX is set up. And yeah, at this level, I don't without like you said, without really looking over it and thinking really hard, I'm not sure immediately based off of that what NPC could have done to alter that control. Yeah, a lot easier to figure out what they could have or should have done in Division E than in Division A. That's certainly a factual statement. So yeah, with both teams dedicating four mechs to trading, when NPC makes their move at Sigma, they only have four mechs to do that, and JGX also has four mechs to contest it, more or less. However, because JGX can pull the mechs at least one, or potentially two mechs from this point here, it then immediately turns it into a 4-on-5, or even a 4-on-6, assuming that this group can hold. So, I mean, I don't know if it's possible. I think, I mean, just a spitball. Maybe they make a really strong push here when they pull someone off of here, then this group tries to do something there. You utilize that mismatch, but again, that's a bit of a reach. So, but we'll go into the next match now. It's a River City Domination. So I'll just s change up my view to make sure we don't radio cast it and get us in there. Looks like they've brought in Scout Derek for NPC. And Bear Claw is the new addition for JGX. Great, great, great tale. Domination. There you go. That's how it's supposed to be said. If you say it differently, you're saying it wrong. All right. JGX, bring in an Annihilator, Viper, Orion. I guess I'll try to get in their views real quick, see what their mechs look like. All right, I'm out of the mechs and the water. So this is domination, less of a cap fight, more of a center fight. Looks like JGX was able to bring the cap down to 40 over a minute. We do have some PPC trading from JGX, who have set up at the high point in the airport, starport, whatever, and they control part of the tower as well. With Bowser's contesting. It looks like Bowser was actually about to go down. He got doubled up by Krabanoski and Dario. Yep, Bowser's out, so they've won the fight for the tower. Meanwhile, NPC is pushing Starport. They've got Mistlynxes now up one of them's up top. JGX's Mistlynx are returning. There's also a few mechs way distant. This Orion and this Nightjar are trying to get them on the back. So it looks like they're trying to squish JGX between their two lines. Unfortunately, for NPC, they're already down one mech because of that early kill by Krabanoski and Dario. And I'm not seeing a lot of. I guess the two guys in the back were able to draw off two mechs, so at least that's even. So it just, if it wasn't, if they weren't down one mech, this fight is assumedly would be even here. Yeah, they've pushed them back. The push ended. We saw Kongo down, Rickrom's about to go down. This Blackliner Scout Derek, he wasn't really part of the push. I'm not sure what his job was back here. Maybe to get angles on them from the side and punish them to draw them off the push, but what we see here is just the mop up action by JGX on the surviving NPC. He just got stuck between them. All right, well, that was a nice quick battle there. I don't know why Bowser made his stand here. I guess he was trying to hold, maybe he was the mech that needed to stand on the domination point. That might have been, as they tried to fight up there, they were forced to sacrifice a mech basically to contest. Damage here says what you'd expect. A lot more damage from JGX and NPC. Seen that Nightjar for Temuid. Looks like he put out the most damage, and he was one of the ones in the backfield, so I'm imagining he got some good shots there, whereas McGoat was the other backfield mech, and he didn't do nearly as well. Kong Lord Rickron were on that push, so was Slipengriff and Pelisseria, and they didn't, got wrecked. Krabanoski got that early kill on Bowser. He had the most damage on his team. And theirs is just a lot more. JGX have a pretty good damage across the board. Yeah. That would maybe change things a little bit. Alpine. All right, I've got the let's switch the map over. River City Domination. There we go. Clean it up. So what it looked like to me was JGX had most of their team set up here, but they had lights up to here, so they kind of controlled. I mean, they effectively controlled this region, I feel like. And then yeah, it looks like Krabanowski tried to get on domination, and it was just 2-on-1. That's a fight you're not gonna win, especially at this competitive level. You don't ever want to get in a 2-on-1 fight like that. From what I could tell, NPC wanted their two traders up here to shoot from here, while their main body pushed up from here, and to kind of bottle up JGX and hit him from two sides, which can be, it could be really rough to be getting shot from two places. However, with the early kill on Bowser, effectively ruining their control. Maybe that's what Derek was doing, Scout Derek, because he was down here. I bet you he was having to hold down domination. So that forced him off of that fight. Two of JGX's mechs went to engage with their two mechs up here, and that 2-on-2 battle ended up, if had NPC successfully killed those two mechs, that could have changed the flow of the game, but they didn't. Instead, both of NPC's mechs died. So, that 2-on-2 went for JGX. This push up here stalled out. They just got ran into a JGX kind of firing arc, ripped them apart, forced them back down, and then they just got ripped apart one by one after that route, as you said it. I'm thinking that maybe the two mechs up here, like part of what they were hoping to do was be able to support Bowser here. So that it. So I mean it's not a bad plan from a NPC. I mean you see what they're trying to do. They anticipated correctly that JGX would take this top area, which really means they're reacting to JGX positioning, which is what happened in the last match. And I think the anticipation of that positioning tells me that both teams feel like this is the strongest point to hold. Because if it wasn't, then NPC wouldn't have planned on that, I suppose. Team one is locked, waiting for team two to lock. Yeah. It's a. I mean, went poorly for NPC there, but really the way it was set up was that NPC to succeed had to do a lot more work than JGX needed to do to succeed in the situation. There were a lot more moving parts for NPC, and you got to appreciate it when they do try to to go at it to try to bottle up JGX. I thought, I understand. I think that's a it's a very good plan. It just, the execution and really what happened down here, like it wasn't even close. And I mean, we saw it from above, but I'm just wondering about, their approach, the way they did it. They got funneled into that area. I gotta wonder if maybe they had. I mean, they brought like two stalkers, so without jump jets, they are, they have only one route. Maybe they have mechs with jump jets. Maybe they have a few other routes and are able to get up there without bottling. That's just an idea. Again, spitballing. All right, switching to the correct view. And we are dropping. Scout Derek is out. That was his moment of glory. He wasn't in a Wolverine dunking on you, though, so you've got that going for him. All right, I'm gonna go through the mechs real quick. Small pulse lasers, light PPCs for the Phoenix Hawk. Looks like that's for fighting lights. ER Larges and the Stalker for Kong Lord. Bowser, small pulse laser. ER Peeps and his Hunchback. Pulse lasers. Pshaw's contesting that point, or So right now we have a lot of contesting happening at Theta. Oops, there we go. JGX have picked up Epsilon and Sigma as well, to NPC having Kappa and Theta. We've got so you can see Data back here kind of covering Theta a bit, or trying to. We saw him initially attempt to actually, I think we saw Pasha attempt to stop Theta Cap. So it looks like NPC did grab Gamma. You can see when Bowser goes into the open, he got hit by three mechs right there. JGX has flipped Theta, and Kapanowski took very little damage for it. You can see Kong Lord up on this mountain. Like mostly trading with a Navid or in the Veagle. Kapanowski's getting out of there. You can see a Pasha Grolsch set up on this hill, able to push up and cover Theta if need be. Bearclaw's smoking a little bit. He's on their left flank. NPC's got two guys in the deep backfield. A Flea and a Phoenix Hawk. Bearclaw's getting pretty beat up in the trades. I'm wondering if those two lights are going to move in and try to make something happen. However, it looks like Dario and Kapanowski are moving in to screen them. So nothing there. Rick Rom and Slip and Griff are throwing stuff down at a Grolsch. And I don't think, I'm assuming they should be able to win. It looks like a 2-on-1 right there between them and Grolsch. Although that Stalker is pretty strong. Goat and Bowser are kind of the center of this. Bowser's a little beat up and is hunchbacked, but yeah, we just got a slow motion trade fight. Looks like the two lights backed off of the north. The NPC's two lights are returning back from Gamma. Percentage wise, Navid and Bearclaw are the most damaged trading mechs at the moment. If they can, so Just waiting for this trade fight. All right, looks like the NPC's lights have regrouped down at Kappa. They're swinging south. I'm assuming they're going to make a move once they've regrouped with whoever they want to group up with. Bowser and Magote seem the least stuck in one spot. Yep, you could see NPC just looking for an opportunity here with all their mechs down here. But Gamma is getting capped, so they just lost Gamma without that screen up there. Which is now 4-2. When they saw Gamma getting capped, that probably was the moment to make a move. They knew one mech was out of the fight, even if it was not opportune. With losing Gamma, they were screwed, so they might as well have just gone all in there and tried to use the mismatch to get something going. Texas Scrub is trying to get Theta, and he's just getting hit too often. He's getting nothing on Theta. They did finally get Bear Claw. Bowser knocked Bear Claw out. So you saw there at the end, JGX lost a few mechs, but by that point it was too late. Tickle fight! You can see that fleeted nothing, but that wasn't his job. There wasn't really any serious light fights till the very, very end anything happened. Pasha and that Hellbringer did a lot of damage, and Bowser and his HB2C, but I mean, as you said earlier, not a lot of storytelling in the scores. You can see Jiffy was a lot less successful in his mech than Bowser was in his. Yeah, it's time to flip the teams. I'll throw the map view up if you wanna manage that. Yeah, good luck. In our next Hibernal Rift. Ha! Here, I'm done moving people around. Let me look what you've done. What you got. Sure. we had, it looked like for the most of the game, Bowser And was it Orion? It wasn't Orion. That makes no sense. We had, yeah, two mechs here. Bowser, another mech. And then it was this hill, right? That, you have Navid here. And then Krapanowski was able to get it without even being scratched at all. Yeah, Bearclaw's mech was probably the weakest, or it was the mech that was going to fall the quickest. So its positioning, just based off of that, had to have been the weakest of everybody. If they were going to knock a mech down, it needed to be that Bearclaw mech. I don't think the guys on I9, I don't think they had shots on Bearclaw very often. Looked like they were more hitting Pasha, who was. I saw them, yeah, I saw them trading with Pasha down here. Yeah, we saw no pre-courses lights eventually make their way up to here. That's the wrong color. Eventually make their way up to here, but they were spotted, and JGX's lights moved up here, and there was nothing that those lights could do. So then they ran all the way back down to here to make something happen. When they pulled out of there, JGX saw that, and they sent a light down into here, to cap Gamma, at which point it was a four cap. Like I said, the only, I mean, this is such a slow tactical trading game, you can't really. It's hard at this point to give a lot of suggestions, but I mean, yeah, the only thing I can add there is just when they knew definitively there was one mech here on Gamma that was capping it, and they had already sucked their lights in, I mean, pretty much up to this point here, that's why that area was now open for that light to cap. That, you know, you're about to get a f Well, I mean, so at that point, rather than focus on, I would win the fight. I'd use the mismatch of it's now 7-on-8. You know, I would roll. They did get a little aggressive, and they were able to take out. They took out two mechs, so they took out a Bearclaw and I think Gorsh, which makes me feel like earlier aggression might have been the answer, especially when it was a mismatch. I mean, you have to at that point. But yeah, what a. Yeah, River City match was relatively fast. But yeah, I don't really think I have anything else to add to this. So our next map up is Hibernal. Hibernal Rift. Domination. Fun fact, I've never played Hibernal Rift competitively. I haven't like looked at it or thought about it in that way before. So I don't know what happens. I don't know what happens in this map. Well, they practically pegged me. No one else wanted to cast this match. So figured it was the end of the tournament, and I'd step in and, be the hero that they deserved. So yeah, I mean, honestly, I don't know anything about Hibernal Rift other than I've been told it's like Canyon Network but with snow. So we'll see if that's how they play it, like Canyon Network but with snow. It is. Is a domination match, so it probably will go a lot quicker. Team 1 is locked, so we're just waiting on JGX to lock and load. And then we will go. See what happens next. Yeah, I guess we'll just look at the lobby now. We don't need to look at this map. Haven't had much lobby view today. Oh, Scout Derek's back in. Rick Rom wasn't in the initial match, but I do recognize Rick Rom. He's old. Been around forever. Yeah. Meanwhile, JGX's roster hasn't really been changing much at all. Other than Bear Claw switching in after that one match. A lot of Data, a lot of Pasha. A lot of Krapanowski, a lot of Navid. So, I haven't even been to the Twitch page. I wonder if anybody's watching this. They want me to get like really excited and scream about stuff? When people are trading at each, I mean, I guess I could have got pumped up for that push in River City. When people are trading at max range, it's hard to be like, it's hard to find that. Yep, that's true. We're If no one's ever seen me, because I've only been casting Division E matches, I generally I'm just pretty technical. Not, I I'm not screaming. All right, both teams are locked. And I switch my view and can launch this match. Let's see what they do today. If it's anything fun. JGX went into this already having won the tournament, but now they've extra won it. NPC had, I mean, they were second place, but they had against the second JGX team, I think they'd only won 3-2. I think there were a few other matches like that for them, so they weren't necessarily they'd had some bumps, it looked like, just looking at the the match scores. See if I can jump in these mechs real quick. Before they all kill each other. That everybody can see what the kids at home are bringing. If you like ERPPCs, now is the time for you. This not the, in the history of the competitiveness of this game. If you're a fan of those kinds of weapons, it looks like this is your time to shine. It seems like most mechs have, if not ERPCs, they're either running some other large laser something damage, or they're running specifically close damage brawl stuff. All right. Loading up into the sky. It looks like CJX was able to get the counter down to halfway before NPC was able to get in the fight. There is a UEV watching the four mechs for NPC kind of move up this channel. Let's look over here. JGX is all set up on this plateau. We've got one mech. I gotta get, there we go. Data in the back, kind of anchoring this approach. Then it looks like we've got their two, well, not two lights. Javelin and Black Lantern are screening up front. Right now, only NPC is in the center. However, they're not getting a countdown yet. Let's see. It looks like Dario is probably getting a toe in there, is my guess. Although it doesn't necessarily look like it. I think he is on domination duty. NPC is rolled around into the side of the firing line. You can see JGX, their mechs backing up to absorb and repositioning. NPC had a few other mechs kind of pushing up the goalie. JGX is now off of the domination. So NPC is tight. They're getting kind of individually traded down a little bit right now, so if they wanted to actually brawl, now would be a time to jump over. Where are the Maulers? Oh, there they are, yeah. I was looking at them the whole time. So we've got a main battle fight here at the Maulers, and then there's a light skirmish going up north as well over here. I'll stay at the Mauler, so I feel like this is what's going to determine the outcome of this battle. Pasha blew himself up in shame. Grolch is getting focused pretty hard by Bowser and Slippin' Griff right now. He's down. Data also went down. I assume that was in the fight to the north. Yeah. Javelin Dario is on Tumuid by himself in the Mauler, but even as that one-on-one's going on, there's a four-on-two happening with Bearclaw getting focused. Krapanowski is regrouping with Dario. There's also a three-on-two happening back here. So yeah, it looks like they got in close, and they jammed up JGX. JGX, we saw, just set up to, fight at range. They brought the weapons to do it, set up to do it, and they weren't ready for almost a brawl push, a medium push, medium range push on top of them. That's a good win for NPC. I'd feel really good about that one. Probably one of the more exciting matches. look at Tumuichin, 8-10 damage in that Mauler. So he really got on that corner. And then you have 664 from Rick Rom. So the Maulers were both really punishing that team. McGoat and his Orion also did 411. You don't have numbers that high from a JGX. They just weren't set up for the ranges they were at, and they weren't able to focus as well with their setup. So yeah, that was a solid change From NPC, I liked it. I feel like they've been doing a lot of the same thing. I mean, River City was different, and this was a domination, so maybe they've decided. And it looks like in the domination matches, JGX is doing the same or a similar thing that they do in their conquest matches, and NPC have been trying to shake it up a little bit, and use the lack of cap control as an opportunity to be a little bit more aggressive. We saw them push in River City, it didn't work. But we saw them push here, and it definitely did work. So, nice. Good. I will throw the map up if you want to sketch that out, like one of your French girls. And I will switch the maps around. Is that? So, JGX, they were set up right here. Is that right? That the where their firing line was initially? Yeah, they had a line here. That where they were? And then they had a mech back. Was this where the other mech was in the back? So yeah, then they had a light to a light and a light a black lantern down here. So I think that was to screen any lights trying to knock them off of it, and then also to control domination. And then they were set up here to I you know do a trade fight, I think. And then what we saw was NPC. They moved up. I mean, they saw them moving. But yeah, especially those Maulers got up here. They got guys here, started sending people over. And then there was a fight up here that I missed most of. But the main event pretty much happened here around that one peak where both the Maulers were, and they wrecked. I think the weapon systems favored NPC, focused fired, and just took down the JGX mechs. I assume the same thing happened over here. I didn't see it. But they did win that fight over there as well. I think there's something to say about complacency, about JGX bringing the same and doing the same thing every time. I mean, it's hard to say a lot about it because they're currently 3-1, so it's not like it's hurting them too badly. There's definitely weaknesses to it. I think. And, I wonder, I know in the previous season, the other JGX team beat the JGX first team on Canyon Network with a pretty, basically a brawl push on top of them. So this may have happened before to this team as well. Not used to fighting this kind of pressure, this kind of tactic. Although, again, you know, River City, they handled it pretty well. I mean, it wasn't a good fight for NPC there. So, good. Exciting to see NPC pull a win out, though. Shake JGX up a little bit. Yeah, I don't got anything else to say about that. I mean, it was good show. Jolly good show, JGX. I mean, NPC. Yeah, I love me some Tourmaline. I've played this map before. I know about it. I haven't seen it in recent times, but I imagine it is not. I don't think things have probably changed too much. Oh, yep, I see that. They're a little bit different. Yeah, we'll see. You know, back in my day, this point was always pretty important right here. Who controlled it, how they controlled it. You know, we're going to see, you know, it's going to be a Theta fight, probably. But, I mean, based where the spawns are, maybe it's different now. I mean, Team 1's way over here. Maybe they set up here. Yep. Yeah, I'm curious to see, now that you've pointed that out, how different it'll be, or how indifferent it'll be. That's not the right word, but I liked it. I wanted to use it. Yeah, I mean, you get a lot of PPC, you get a lot of range mechs just hiding up here, being annoying. So we'll see how well, you know, these areas get used, especially from these locations. It will be different, you're right. Yep, just call me Ash. I saw that wasn't impressed that I was a caster these days, but you know, if he can pretend that he plays for EMP, I can pretend that I'm a shoutcaster. So that's my feeling on that one. You know, we all got our glass houses. All right, Team 1 is locked, so I'm just waiting for JGX to lock up. We'll drop this and finish out this round. And this is the final week for the Marshall Olympiad Reborn 2. So that's it for these teams. I know there is a Tournament of Stars coming up. However, word is that JGX will not be participating in that. Krapanowski has been sending off his people to try to join other units. He keeps trying to give people to me because word on the street is Isengrim might actually compete again, but well, either way, his JGX members, they can go somewhere else. All right. Well, then we will do the thing where we drop. I will switch out my views. Oh, I already was in the wrong view. Great! It didn't matter. Never happened, never will. Now you said that, I'm going to double check. Yeah, we're good. Everything's good. People are pinging me in the MWO comp Discord. They're probably all mad at me for things I've said. Yeah. When they begged for us to shoutcast this match. Oh, like there's enough EMP members that NPC now actually has a team name, which is Imperial. All right, I'm gonna jump through these mechs real quick, starting with a Grotius ER large mech. Just so that people who are watching this back home can know what everybody brought. Yeah. Right, I think that's everybody. All right, so we saw there, as I jumped through real quickly, there was a little bit of a brawl at Theta. Both teams made a move for it. Looks like Imperial. Yeah, well, every time I look, I see Imperial now. Looks like Imperial made a m or NPC made a move for it and took it, a stronger move. Let's see. We've got NPCs got the Summoner Grasshopper P in the back. What do we call this? A stage. And then we've got a up closer Viper, Firestarter, and the Bowser and his Hunchback 2C. More of a doing a little bit close range fight. I mean, they're not close range, but closer up. Meanwhile, JGX has set up their Stalker and their Direwolf back here on this thing. So Polly is also trading in this Firestarter against looks like the Kodiak Kong Lord is set up way out here on the right flank. And then yeah, we've got mechs capping. So we can see NPC slash EMP have a pretty long firing line with Kong on the right. And now it's just trading. Looks like they forced the most of the mechs off here. Data just got struck. He's getting a little bit beat up. The JGX is repositioning some of their traders. Rolsh is now up front, and Jiffy has moved up as well. Damage-wise, we can see Data's hurting pretty bad. And Pasha's taking a little bit of damage for JGX, whereas Kong, I think Kong took most of his damage getting into position. So I don't think he's not bleeding now. We saw the. We can see a right rotation by JGX, especially with their black laner and their black laner and their Incubus. Followed up by the Firestarter a little bit in the rear. They keep striking Kong. Just Call Me is now getting jumped by that group that we watched, and they took him down quick. The Viper Slip and Griff tried to support. He was a little bit late to the party, and now he is getting isolated hard. There's not a lot of other movement going on. Or I guess reactions, let's say, from Yeah, Krabanoski took some damage there. Looks like they're backing off, or trying to. Bowser, ooh. Right there. He's pretty beat up. Opportunity might have been there for them to take him. Let's see. General Tr The main trading mechs doesn't look like they've altered too much. The stage mechs are involved. Looks like Krapanowski's up. This Firestarter and the Summoner are up here also trading now. All right. So Bowser and Scout Derek are pretty messed up. Krabanowski's also a little hurt. I think if Bowser and Scout fall, though, it's pretty much over. We can see Kong in this trading corner has also taken damage. I'm imagining it's probably mostly from strikes. I saw him get struck a few times, but I just haven't been following that because what's happening in this corner is much more interesting. They're going in. Crap's going in for Bowser. Getting hit from above, though. He lost a lot of damage there. Navid destroyed Pella. All right, we just lost the Fire Starter and Bowser. They did get a Krabanowski though, and now they got Slip and Griff. So yeah, things are collapsing for NPC. We see a Magote trying to back up. Their traders are probably able to step forward now for JGX, just present and force them down. Rickroms way back here in his Direwolf. They're now flipping the caps. Yep. Looks like Kong is. Or is that Kong? Or is that a. Someone was hitting Grosh pretty good. The goat getting a shot on Jiffy there. Rickrom died. He was the healthiest one a second ago. I don't know what happened to Rickrom. I was gonna jump inside him, but he died too fast. Right. Do 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 do. So we got Bowser trying to do work in his Hunchback 2C. That Kodiak Kong Lord, he was taking a lot of damage throughout the match, but he ended up putting up a lot from that corner. Rickrom and Magote both did pretty well as well. Pshaw, 670, doing a lot of work in that Night Gear. Grolsch and a Stalker also doing work, and Data. So really good trade mix from them. And then, Jiffy did well as well. That Grasshopper, just call me Ash. He died early. We saw him get jumped, but it didn't seem it's not a huge impact from him in that fight. Right, and they must have not seen it coming because it took him a moment to react as well. I mean that he didn't move at all from that position, and then it was almost a one on. They almost got the next mech Slippin' Griff before he was able to pull back and get reinforcements maneuvered over to his position. So yeah, you are right. With the new spots, the new starting locations, it is a lot different than it used to be. I haven't quite seen that. Kong was over here. I think early on, the initial trade setup must have favored JGX or not JGX, NPC, because NPC pulled most of their traders up, and then started trading from this line. Although, let's see, was the Grasshopper? Yeah, this is where Ash was, right? Yep. Yep. That's pretty much what sinked it, was the success of that kill squad. Taking out Ash, and then just putting pressure right here constantly putting pressure. It forced a lot the mechs over here and up here to kind of rotate more in that area to try to cover their mechs, which exposed them more, created new opportunities for the trading mechs to get shots on them, and just really kind of bottled up NPC in this area. I mean, they still had, one or two mechs back here, and you saw Kong did the most damage back here as well, so there were still opportunities, but bottled up. I think the damage coming from the side and then the damage coming from this side just created too many opportunities for NPC to bleed life. Yeah, that's all I got to say about that. I'm looking at the Discord. I don't see anybody talking to me. So I'm imagining they don't want to say their words at us, which is fine. Yep. So yeah, that's JGX going in, had already won it. They have now, nothing has changed, and nothing could have changed. They went 4-1 against NPC. I feel like we saw NPC really catch them out on drop 4. Otherwise, though, it was pretty steadily JGX's match throughout the rest of it. So I don't know. I think we're done. All right. Well, yeah, it was good for me. I need to see more so that I can make better commentary. Yeah. I think we've made it to Division D casting. So congratulations, us. But yeah, thanks. Thanks everybody for tuning in for this match. Yeah, I just started reading the chat. Have me tuned in. All right, well, goodbye. There'll be more matches streamed tonight, maybe tomorrow. I don't know. I'll be doing another one later. But I will stop streaming now. So take care, everybody. Have a fun Saturday if you're American. If you're not, whatever. It's not my problem.